Welcome back, this is Eric. Today I'm gonna show you how I built an AI-powered object tracking camera using ESP32P4. This thing can detect 80 different objects, people, cars, umbrellas, you name it, and track them with servo motors. Now, I need to be upfront with you. This runs at about 1.3 frames per second. Unfortunately, this is not a fast tracking system, but I learned a lot from testing it. First, let me explain what I'm trying to do. Before that, you can check out the hardware information for this device in the previous video. Expressive provides this library called ESP-DL that's deep learning with pre-trained models for object detection. They have a YOLO model that can detect 80 different objects, people, cars, dogs, cats, sports balls, umbrellas, the COCO dataset. My goal was simple, use the camera to detect objects, then control the servers to track them, like a smart security camera that follows you around. And it works. The camera detects objects, the servers smoothly track the largest detection, and everything runs in real time on this microcontroller. Well, real time at about 1.3 fps. It's still not easy to build a fast and accurate detection system on a microcontroller, but let me explain why that's actually pretty impressive. Okay, so here's where we need to talk about realistic expectations. When I first looked at this documentation, I saw this benchmark showing different timing numbers. And I will be honest, I initially misunderstood what I was looking at. See that 600 milliseconds for the actual AI inference. That's about 1.6 frames per second under ideal conditions. Yeah, I totally misread the benchmark table at first. I thought the inference was only 5.6 milliseconds. Nope, that's the pre-processing. The actual AI model takes 600 milliseconds to run. And you know what? That's actually amazing for a microcontroller. Think about it, we are running a full neural network with 80 object classes on a 20 box chip with no GPU, no fancy accelerators, just 400 MHz RISC-V cores with INT8 hardware. The ESP32P4 isn't the fastest, but look at the price point and power consumption. For 10 to 20 bucks and just 1 to 2 watts, you are getting real AI inference capability. For battery-powered IoT applications, this power efficiency is absolutely critical. You could run the ESP32P4 on a small battery for hours or days, while just nano is draining much faster. So there you have it, my AI-powered object tracking camera running on the ESP32P4. Yeah, I know, it'll be really nice if it worked faster. Oh, and one more thing, if you only need to detect one specific type of object instead of 80 different classes, there's much faster option. It's showing dedicated pedestrian detection using the Pico model. Instead of using COCO detect with 80 classes, this specialized Pico model focuses on just detecting people and it's much faster. The Pico model takes only 51 milliseconds for inference on the ESP32P4 compared to 600 milliseconds for YOLO. That's over 10 times faster. If your application only needs to find one specific thing, pedestrian, faces, or whatever, consider using a specialized single-class detector instead of the multi-class COCO model. You'll get way better performance. Alright. That's all for today. The next project will probably be even more interesting. See you in the next project.